Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. Booster 9 successfully completed its full-duration static fire on Friday, the 25th of August, at 12:36 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Among 33 Raptor engines, only two engines fell short of completing the entire test run, leaving us curious about the reasons behind these shutdowns. In the latest trial, SpaceX made timing adjustments between the bidet system startup and the ignition of the booster. The interval, which was around 6.5 seconds on the August 6th test, was reduced to 4 seconds for this test. Furthermore, ignition commenced approximately 1.5 seconds earlier after their weir pipe valves were closed. This means that ignition now happens only 0.5 seconds after reaching the maximum flow rate, instead of the previous 2 seconds. Notably, a significant portion of the water is transformed into invisible dry steam during this process, while any remaining water is pushed beneath the flames and down to the ground, becoming hard to detect. Even the small amount of remaining water is rapidly atomized, compounding the challenge of spotting it amidst the flames. The execution appeared smooth, confirmed by SpaceX, as Booster 9's road and pad were closed and cleared for the static fire. Propellant loading was well underway, and the frost line was creeping up on SpaceX's Booster 9, with the LOX tank starting to frost over, as indicated by vent fog. Before the static fire test, there was a pre-static fire, Fire X checkout on the OLM, and then B9 was ignited. It's interesting to note that even at 50% power, the Super Heavy has more thrust than a fully powered Falcon Heavy. During the static fire, the flame deflector demonstrated improvement compared to the previous test, when a noticeable change in water pressure followed engine shutdown. Residents of Boca Chica Village were alerted about Booster 9 testing through an overpressure notice. Anticipation remains high to witness Booster 9's full thrust during IFT2. But that was not the only news that took us to the edge of our seats. A recent NOTAM, or Notice to Airmen, issued by the U.S. Coast Guard, has revealed that SpaceX might be aiming for Starship's second launch attempt as early as September 8th. Initially, the target date was August 31st for the IFT-2, Integrated Flight Test 2. However, there are some essential steps that SpaceX needs to complete before this launch can proceed smoothly. Currently, they're in the process of conducting additional pre-flight tests and are awaiting an official launch license from the FAA, which implies that the September 8th date might be subject to change. Now, if the static fire test of Booster 9 was successful, according to SpaceX, the critical tasks remaining include ensuring the readiness of the full stack involving Booster 9 and Ship 25, conducting a thorough wet dress rehearsal, obtaining the FAA's green light, and ultimately executing the launch. So, in the last video, we saw SpaceX's Booster 9 embark on a significant journey as it rolled out to the orbital launch pad. Let's see what happened after that. Once it arrived at the launch pad, a crucial step followed: the meticulous process of hoisting Booster 9 onto the orbital launch mount, or OLM, to facilitate the booster's testing and eventual launch. With precision and care, Booster 9 was securely positioned atop the OLM. To ensure its reliability and safety, Booster 9 was thoroughly readied for pre-flight assessments. As this process unfolded, the anticipation grew, with numerous other vehicles in line for their own rounds of testing, underscoring the bustling activity and dedication at the SpaceX facility. In parallel to these activities, the subcoolers were initiated. The orbital launch mount also played its role by releasing gases, hinting at the possibility of preparing for the booster's cryogenic loading. Booster 9 underwent a controlled cryogenic loading. Following this, the Fire X test was initiated, marking a significant milestone in the assessment of the booster's systems and capabilities. Ahead of the spin prime test, Booster 9 ensured that its grid fins were working properly. Subsequently, the booster went through a spin prime test. The spin prime test proceeded according to plan. We saw water deliveries were in progress. To facilitate this, a crane that was previously occupying the area has been repositioned, clearing the way for the water delivery process. In addition to these preparations, there's a notable presence of Marvin, which is the LR-11000 machine. This machine has been moved to a safe distance, indicating a deliberate effort to ensure its protection. Meanwhile, expressing his expectations, Elon Musk wrote, "Next Starship launch soon," as a response to the firm's Booster 9 update, featuring four photographs showcasing the rocket's relocation. While commendable strides are evident, the specific departure of Booster 9 and Ship 25 remains uncertain. It's essential to view Musk's soon projection cautiously, as he often reveals ambitious target timelines, and the exact schedule in the instance is not solely within his control. On the other hand, on Wednesday morning, India achieved a significant milestone by becoming the fourth nation to successfully land a spacecraft on the moon, joining the ranks of the United States, Russia, and China. Notably, the Chandrayaan spacecraft accomplished this feat by touching down on the moon's southern pole, marking India's distinction as the first country to achieve such a landing. The purpose of this mission is to comprehensively study the moon's geological characteristics, particularly with the aim of identifying valuable resources like water that could potentially serve as fuel and sustenance for future lunar bases established by any nation. The magnitude of this accomplishment is undeniable, considering the substantial investment of approximately $75 million made by India's space agency to cover the entire process from development and launch to the successful landing of the probe. In contrast, the annual budget of NASA, the United States Space Agency, is approximately $20 billion, underscoring the impressive nature of India's lunar endeavor amidst a thriving era of celestial exploration. However, in the modern space industry, two notable companies, SpaceX and Rocket Lab, have convincingly demonstrated that achieving a viable and prosperous space business doesn't demand an extravagant budget of billions of dollars, but rather a more modest investment in the range of hundreds of millions. This revelation underscores a significant shift in the economics of space ventures. Illustrating this trend, on a recent Wednesday evening, according to Eastern Time, Rocket Lab celebrated a remarkable feat as they successfully executed their 40th mission. Employing their reliable Electron rockets, they seamlessly dispatched a satellite into low Earth orbit, catering to the needs of Capella Space. What's truly remarkable is that they achieved this milestone while incorporating an engine that had been used in a previous launch, showcasing the viability of reusability and cost-effectiveness. But in a world where space exploration continues to captivate our imaginations, SpaceX emerges as a true beacon of innovation and progress. With each rocket launch, with every payload delivered, the company's impact on shaping the future of humanity's relationship with the cosmos becomes all the more evident. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.